Jackfruit, okay, and Ambadi, okay, good. Something that you can take a little bit with your paratha or roti or ghee, yes. So are we all eating ghee now? Yeah, well done. And did you all listen to the Facebook Live yesterday? Yeah. So you do know that San Francisco is now serving ghee along with French toast. Yeah. So what's happening is that the world is now opening to the many, many possibilities of including Indian and native food into their diet. On the other hand, people like us seem to turn away from most stuff that is homegrown in our kitchens. So it's high time we adopt it, because eating ghee is useful for the skin, it's useful for weight loss, it's useful for joints and backaches, and it's also useful for, I have to go back, okay. Sorry, this is better. Okay, and it's also better for, dealing with contractions. It's better for dealing with pregnancy cravings. So ghee is good for everything. But then there is one more food, which is the forgotten food, which we almost see like a villain in our diet. And that food is achar. Oh, how many of us are eating achar? Okay, very good. नहीं तो एक time पे हिंदी old हिंदी movies में जब बहू आचार मांगती थी तो mother-in-law would get happy, because that was the indication that she is probably going to deliver good news, which is her pregnancy. But what we now know, and it's info that you will find obviously in the book, is that women who are planning to get pregnant should surely be eating achar, the kind of achar that we make at home. And not be saying, oh God, so much oil, so much salt, huh? Because we all kind of know now, after Indian superfoods, that in 2015, USDA reversed its guideline on cholesterol. You all know this, right? So now it's all of a sudden become very okay to
Manju, my friend.
आए जरा पीछे आओ ना, अभी आगे की चढ़ गई ना,
कौन जा रहा
है?
करीबन यहाँ पे, यहीं पे कर ले फोटो,
यहीं पे कर ले,
यहाँ पे
करीबन
यहाँ पे
Fashion icon and a woman who redefined motherhood for the whole nation, Kareena Kapoor Khan. Ladies and gentlemen, can we please give her a huge round of applause? Where is Rujita? Maybe, okay. Rujita, back on the stage again, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, Rujita and Kareena, I would request you to first unveil the book before you sit down for the discussion, please. Thank you. Please, niche. Yeah, all of the still photographers, please. Please keep to the ground, please. Thank you. pregnancy notes, before, during and after by Rujuta Divekar, ladies and gentlemen. A louder applause, please. Come on. Thank you. That's more like it. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. May I please request all of you to take your seats now?
Mics.
Please, all your mobile phones should be on silent mode. And I would request all of you to please. Rujuta, may I now request you to please start the conversation?
Okay, so just to give you a quick update, while you were coming, we were chatting a bit about what to eat before pregnancy, during pregnancy, post it, what to eat for like vitamin D and iron levels and stuff. So we've already done a little bit of a Q&A, but now you need to tell us what do you think is the most important message in the book?
I think the most important message in the book is the fact that Rujuta has even written a pregnancy book. I think everybody writes diet books, exercise books, yoga books. Of course, Rujuta has also done, I think, one of the biggest books to have come out of India, How Don't Lose Your Mind, Lose Your Weight. I think this is a one of a kind because, I mean, for every woman, I think everybody's a little nervous, anxious, scared the first time you become a mother, the first time you get pregnant. So an informative book which guides you through, I think, the journey, which is so very special, which you get a lot of jitters, nervousness. Sometimes you overeat, undereat. There's so many things taking place during pregnancy. So I think this is literally going to be a pregnancy Bible for a lot of women. And I'm so happy that we've done this together. And I'm here today to launch this book that's finally out. It's an exciting moment. And I'm sure this one's going to be even bigger than Don't Lose Your Mind, Lose Your Weight.
Well, thank you for that. But, you know, we've been together since Don't Lose Your Mind, Lose Your Weight. And I think like all the trends that you have propelled, Don't Lose Your Mind, Lose Your Weight also propelled another trend of, you know, actors endorsing diet books. Don't you think so?
Yes. I mean, of course. I think that definitely, I think that was the first time that I think, you know, actually so openly had written about the diet fads and what kind of right eating was about. I think in India, everyone was very averse to eating right. Everybody thought they were eating right, but nobody was really implementing that. And the fact that when Rujuta really came out and openly spoke about, you know, how women actually, not just women actually, I think even men, they lose their mind more than they lose inches on their waist. Because people in the gym ke mare ja rahe, 4 ghante mare ja rahe. Ke kya ho raha hai? But nobody's really losing weight. So I think the idea being is that, you know, you have somebody to guide you. And I think, yes, ever since then, there have been gazillions and thousands of books up that.
Yeah, so in a way, you actually made the book industry, got them rolling.
Huh? Yeah, there was no such thing as a diet section pehle. Now there's a health section.
There have been a lot of firsts. Yeah. And especially with me, including the paparazzi and the media, if I would like to take credit. The whole gym session, the whole gym look. Tum log ne kya yaar, pura Reebok, Adidas, Nike khali ho gaya. Sab mere ghar pe hai. Ki yaar, every day wo pressure ho gaya ki kuch pehno, kuch naya pehno. Kareena ne kya pehna hai gym mein. So everything, there's a first. Huh?
Yeah, yeah.
So it's fine. But it's okay. I love it and I love my photographers. And please follow me and please click me. I don't care.
And as much as you want.
As much as you want.
Okay, cool. So what do you think was the one food that really helped you sail through your pregnancy and post it, especially because when you lost weight post-pregnancy, you know, it was almost like tushin because everyone's like, oh God, what is she doing? You know, why is she losing so much weight?
No, I think that in fact it's a very gradual process because it's, yes, it has been 6 months, but like I said, that it's going to be this whole 1 year. You know, we're going to do it the right way. We're going to eat the right kind of food. Just so everybody knows, of course, I had today, it was, I had lots of ghee. You know, I mean, I told him that even in my dal, there should be a little bit of it. That I enjoyed the taste. And I think that also it's literally helping me, keeping my skin, my hair, everything is like feeling great. And the most important, I'm also very happy. So I think a happy mother is the best mother in the world.
Yes, I think, some loud applause to that because the book is also meant for women who are working and to really ensure that women do take the time off to look after themselves. Because like she rightly said, a happy mother is the best mother that a child can have. And not a skinny mother is the best mother that a child can have, you know. And happy women invariably look fit and are healthy and are, yeah.
Absolutely. I think that's so important, because being a mother, of course, carrying the child for 9 months, then giving birth, looking after the child after that. I think there's a lot that comes into it, a lot that comes into play, mentally, physically, hormonally. So many things are taking place, you know, which I think even women sometimes don't even know what they're going through. So I think the most important thing is that to figure out an eating plan, eat right, eat every 2 hours, eat the right kind of food. In fact, in the book, what is most important is that you've given tips on each trimester.
Yes.
Which is, I think, brilliant. Because so many different things are actually taking place in each trimester, you know. The last trimester being for the brain development, which is actually so important. So what exactly will help for that? I think all that information is out there.
And another very important message that we send, that we want to send out there is that too many women obsess only about what to eat once they're pregnant or after they have delivered because, you know, they would just like to quickly lose that weight. But what is of paramount importance is that what is it that you were eating much before you got your pregnant? Much before you got pregnant, because your pregnancy and how quickly you get back in shape post-delivery is very much dependent on what kind of health status you had before.
Your fitness levels, basically, how, of course, you know, being eating right, exercise, it's been a combination of that even pre-pregnancy. Of course, Rujita being one of the first ones that I called when I actually made up my mind that I wanted to have a child.
Yeah.
I actually called her up and I said, listen, this is what I'm planning. Obviously, don't tell anyone, but let's work towards it because I really want to be fit. And, if I'm fit before that, I think that it's, I'm going to, sail through. And, of course, with the support of, so many people, everyone, my friends, family, Rujita, everybody, I think it's been a well-documented pregnancy and a pregnancy that I think has just, flown by. So it's actually made me feel that, wow, okay, I can. Maybe should I do it again?
Yeah, so I think, the way that it was this whole size zero thing and it really inspired a whole lot of people. It actually changed the way people were dieting. People are now looking at Indian food to lose their weight. Similarly, I think post your pregnancy, no one's going to feel scared of getting pregnant because, because you've kept up with your work and you've kept up with your glam quotient all throughout.
Well, I don't know about that. I think that I've always just done, like you know me, it's always about what, just following my heart. And basically, I think just being clean, happy, positive thoughts. That also is, I think, the most important thing, you know, when you're carrying your child, even post delivery. So many thoughts come to your mind, but actually, food is also related a lot to the brain and the way you think, you know. So the key and the crux is that, you know, if you keep your gut clean, automatically, you know, your brain, everything is just cleansed completely. And that's what I've always done for the last 10 years since we've been together.
Absolutely. But do you think that it's, because this is the common perception that people have, that, you know, it's easier for stars to come out there and say, be positive and eat clean, and it's not so for us common people. What would you want to say to that?
In fact, I think it's easier for the common people to kind of eat clean, because there's nothing really that we're doing that's out of the box.
Correct.
I think we're actually eating what's completely normal and what's made at home. It's basic home food. I mean, you know, even that's why I hate going out, you know. I don't like going to parties or restaurants, because I think the idea is that I'd rather enjoy like a nice movie on television and eat a home cooked meal. So I mean, how hard is that, you know? I mean, like a basic dal rice, if that can help you lose weight, you know, why bother about all the expensive goji berries and the, you know, cranberries and the so on so forth? I think it's not that important.
Staying rooted is important.
Absolutely. Being true to your culture is important.
Yes. Do you think that it almost needs a special kind of confidence to be eating out of our kitchens, given the kind of propaganda that we have every single day about ye khao, wo khao, har ek imported cheese khao to knock the weight off?
Yeah, I think that most of the thing is that, you know, we just kind of read items blindly. We kind of believe whatever information is, you know, out there. If somebody's written a blog, if somebody said this, that now so-and-so is doing this diet or so-and-so is doing that, I think then we obviously turn away from our own home-cooked food, our own kitchens, and kind of try and, you know, go to the expensive stores and say that, okay, this, it has to be good because, you know, it's like 5,000 rupees.
Yeah.
And it's a miracle drug, or it's like, you know, it's going to work because everyone's eating it in the West. But I think that Indians and our DNA is completely different. At least I can say it from me, that I'm a true blue Punjabi and my DNA is completely different. So I need to have Indian food. I need to have, you know, the basic home-cooked meal, you know, even to keep me healthy and happy.
And would you like to have a message for all the husbands about learning to cook?
Yeah, well, of course. But now, you know, I mean, that goes without saying that my husband is playing the role of a chef, but he also is, not many people know, is also a very good chef. And but though, I mean, like, he gets very scared if I tell him, like, cook a dal and, you know, like, something like a ghar ka sabzi, he panics. He does the pasta really well. But, yeah, he is a little anglicized, yeah. So he's allowed to.
True. And what role do you think exercise plays, you know, in pregnancy and post it, in staying happy and staying fit?
No, I think being active in pregnancy is the most important thing. And that's what I did. I mean, just, you know, being out and about, you know, going... But your day-to-day normal chores, as normal as it can be, you know. I mean, like, but of course, the Indian mentality, I'm sure, is a little bit like, you know, ki are ghar pe baitho, khana tray pe aa raha hai, ghar pe, all the women are with their feet are swollen. You know, they kind of have that thing that, are, I can't do this, I can't do that. But, you know, I think things are changing now, you know. I mean, there's so many people who are 7-8 months pregnant and you can see them, they're on the go, they're on the move, and they are inspirational. So I think that the idea was, even for me, I was like, I want to just be out. I want to just do everything that's normal and, you know, just keep my, you know, positivity, keep my brain cool, keep calm. You know, that's the most important.
Yeah. And what would you like to say about, you know, going to bed on time and de-stressing? Because that's something that you've really started doing now.
Yeah, of course. I mean, like, I think that has also changed now because of Taimur, because I like sleeping early and I like waking up early because he sleeps early and of course he's up at 7 a.m. So the idea is that I think that's helped me, you know, get into this routine, that's helped me be fitter, is getting my 8-9 hours of sleep at the right time, you know, not sleeping at 2 in the morning and, you know, 3 in the morning. It's lights out at 10:30. Of course, on weekends, it's exceptional. Today being a Saturday night.
Correct. So do you also think that, you know, happier mothers, fitter mothers, active mothers contribute to the health of a baby?
I mean, I think the baby automatically, your child will feel what you're feeling somehow. You know, mothers and, you know, their child, there's an instant bond, there's an instant connection. So you need to be happy, you need to feel it from inside, you know, when you're holding your child. So I think that is most important. And trust me, that comes with, you know, a balanced meal of eating, you know, the right kind of stuff.
Did you have any kind of routine pregnancy problems?
I mean, pregnancy problems. I mean, of course, even I had morning sickness and, you know, like what everybody, what most normal women are going through. But I think, yeah, of course, we kind of kept it at bay with lots of sugar, lots of kala namak. Like, and Rujita has an answer, like, that's for everything. And the most simplest remedies. So I think the crowd should actually ask you also.
No, I think, you know, instead of just chatting with each other, maybe we could take a few questions from the crowd right now. So,
yes.
You know, now that the lady herself is here, if you have any questions, you can ask them. But keep them related to the book and, you know, health, fitness, pregnancy, all of that. Mm-hmm.
And also, before you ask a question, please identify yourself.
Yeah. So put your hand up, yeah. Is that what you want them to do? Yeah.
Hi, Karina.
Hi.
Do you need a mic from Maharashtra Times?
Hi. Poonam Singh from Maharashtra Times. Hi. You look healthy.
Thank you.
Yeah. We talk about the physical health. Apne physical health mein abhi bahut baat ki. Tell me about the mental health. Mental health apne in duration mein, is duration mein kaise maintain kiya? Ke kuch dekhte the, padhte the?
Nee, of course, I think that throughout pregnancy ki puri jo journey thi, I think usme I think I automatically had such a positive pregnancy. Jo maine man ko aur dimag ko, I think I really kept myself with family, friends, people that I love, people who care for me. I think all that has also kept me going. And jaise maine kaha ki automatically if you're eating right, I think mental health is also related very strongly to that.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah. You could pass the mic.
Yeah. Hi, Karina. My name is Taiba. I'm from Republic TV. You're always known to be the person who's, you know, started the trend of size zero. So after your delivery, what was the pressure on you to, you know, come back to your size and dealing with media showing, oh my God, she's gained all the weight. So how difficult was you and how did you handle the pressure?
But I think because it's the most normal thing that a woman goes through is childbirth. Mm-hmm. And I mean, I think that every woman puts on, you know, a few kilos. That is very important, you know. I mean, it does happen. It happens naturally. And I think the idea there was I never felt any pressure. The idea of me going to work out or going to the gym or kind of eating right was always from the fact that I want to just feel good. I want to feel good about myself. I want to feel happy. I want to feel right. So if I'm going to the gym, it's not about getting to size zero, honestly, you know. I mean, so many people and so many girls are like, oh, why does she have to leave her baby and go to the gym? I mean, I genuinely read these comments and I'm like, I think that's the most stupid thing ever because, I mean, having a child doesn't mean that, you know, you can't feel good and you don't have the fact that you can go to the gym for an hour. If your mental health is right, you know, and, you know, the kind of brain, even brains have hormones. If they are feeling right, automatically, you know, your day goes well, the mood is happy, everybody's happy, you know. So it's not about, there's absolutely no pressure, honestly. I'm one of the most relaxed, chilled out, pressureless girls. I don't listen, I do what I think is right.
I think that is what is the most special thing about her. And I would also like to add that the whole size zero term was also something that we first heard from the media, and that is one of the big reasons why Don't Lose Your Mind, Lose Your Weight was a success, thanks to everyone within the media. So at any point that you feel like you should come and ask me for a royalty from all the books that we have sold.
That's a good chance.
Yeah.
So after listening to you, I remember the movie
which movie?
Jab We Met, and main meri favorite hu. That's what the pregnancy or the woman should think, right?
Of
I think
course.
That will get her out quickly.
I think that line is iconic because it just symbolizes what every woman should feel. That's yes. Main apni favorite hoon. And I am my favorite.
Good.
And keep I will always up. Be my favorite.
That's a good message.
And that's
thank
why
you.
I will be a happy person. And that's the most important. And I will always be fit and healthy. Of course, the men can also say that.
Okay.
We are all thank saying you. That even as women.
Anyone from the members of the media?
I think the first thing we're going to do is gift Soha this book. That is, I think, going to really, really help her. And also, I think wo khud hi itni fit hai. Khud hi wo, I think she's carrying her pregnancy so, so beautifully. Also, I think she's looking very, 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 very cute. इसमें डाइट लिखा है प्रेगनेंसी का डाइट लिखा है बट आप फॉलो कर सकते हो ये ग्लो आ जाएगा आप पे भी आ जाएगा
Hi Kareena, this is Mini from India Today. So how has this new blessing in your life changed your choice of choosing projects? I mean, we all love Taimur. Wherever he goes, he's being papped wherever he goes. So how do you manage to leave him and how do you manage to balance your personal and professional life now?
No, I think I've always had like a personal life and a professional life. But of course now it is, you know, it is more difficult. But I'm going to try and strike a balance. And, you know, I mean, we're starting the shoot of the movie, so he will come with me. But he also, you know, the father has to take a little bit of responsibility. That's where Ki and Ka come in.
Okay, anyone from the media who would like to ask a question?
करीना बहुत सारे जो स्टार्स होते हैं वो नहीं चाहते कि उनके न्यू बॉर्न बेबीज़ जो हैं बहुत जल्दी मीडिया के सामने आए बट तैमूर को देखकर और आपको देख के ऐसा नहीं लगता लगता है कि आप लोग बहुत यू पीपल आर वेरी ओके विद दैट सो इज देयर एनी स्पेशल रीजन फॉर दैट
आई थिंक दैट यू नो आई मीन अभी कल्चर बहुत बदल गया आई थिंक जहाँ जाओ एवरीबडी इज़ यू नो क्वाइट ओपन एवरीबडी इज़ कैरिंग फोटोग्राफ्ड एवरीबडी इज़ यू नो If you go out also or to the gym, anywhere you're getting photographed. And he's as normal. Taimur is as normal as anybody else. So why should he be treated that he's not normal? His parents are normal. I mean, his friends will be normal. So we want to. And it's fine. It's absolutely okay. It's his journey. It's his life.
Thank you.
And apart from that, I think he is probably the most amazing and cutest child ever. So it's fine.
Yeah, true.
Thank you. And we just have one last question.
Hi.
Let's take, okay, you've already had your chance, sir, please.
Kareena,
let's take one question from the audience, please.
Kareena, hi. Towards your left, yeah, Priyanka. Kareena, what are the tips that you're giving Sara right now that she's making her debut in Bollywood?
But y'all are asking me that I'm supposed to give tips to everybody in my family, but why? I'm not a teacher. I'm also busy in my life.
But what are the kind of interactions that you both are having right now?
I think that, you know, I'm sure she's going to be supremely talented because she has it in her genes. And I mean, she's looking amazing. She's looking gorgeous. And I truly believe that with her beauty and her talent, I mean, she's going to rock the industry for sure.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. No, thank you. We're running short on time. Yeah. Media.
All right, I just have one last thing to add about the book, that the book also has a lot of crowdsourced recipes for the very first time. So you will actually have recipes from women across India who have written about, you know, what are the special foods for every trimester. So that's in the book.
Important.
Yeah.
Poonam wanted a book, na?
Poonam. Yeah.
Oh, all the best.
She can just read the book, huh?
Okay, the group bites will happen now. So members of the media, if you want to please come right in front immediately with your boom boxes, please.
Yeah,
you've taken? Okay. Great. Yeah, please. Table nahi hat sakta hai? Yeah. You can take the picture quietly. Yes. Against the book.
Solo.
Okay. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for coming and being a part of this event.
तुम क्या बता रहे हो? फोटो कौन बैठा है? करीना